Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. A very good day to you all. In this video, I'm going to talk about example 1.3 in the Shigley Mechanical Engineering Design textbook. Okay. I encourage you to have the textbook with you because you can practice. Okay. This is the example that I'm going to discuss. I'm going to explain. I hope you can have additional knowledge on this. Okay. So example 1.3 is situated in chapter 111, design factor and factor of safety. Okay. So the question says that a vertical round rod is used to support a hanging weight. A person will place the weight and end without dropping it. Diameter of the rod can be manufactured within 1% of its nominal dimension. The support ends can be centered within 1.5% of the nominal diameter dimension. The weight is known within 2% of nominal weight. The strength of the material is nominal value, and the nominal strength equation equals to P over A, as in previous example. Determine what design factor should be used so that stress does not exceed the strength. Okay, I believe that you can do this practice. Okay. From my experience, you can do this practice, but maybe you don't know what is the meaning of this question happen. Okay. So this question, okay, will account the real world factors in mechanical stress calculation. Okay. There are eccentric loading. Okay, because the load may not be perfectly centered, causing additional bending stress due to misalignment. Okay. When you put a load, it will never be perfectly at center. Okay. It must be slightly left, slightly right, slightly front, slightly back. Okay. It is like that. So it is called eccentric loading. Okay. So when the structure have eccentric loading, it will cause bending. Okay, it will cause extra stress on the eccentric factor. So we must account for that factor. So when we that is why in the question that they says about the tolerances for plus minus plus one tolerance plus 1.5 tolerance meaning that it will this kind of eccentricity will always happen in real life. Okay, you can put anything on your table, on your structure, on your hole and everything, it will never be perfectly centered. Okay, so okay, so what should we do is we calculate the account for the additional safety factor lah. So the design factor is introduced to ensure the component withstand worst case scenarios. Okay. So, impact of real-world forces on mechanical components. There are dynamic load, sudden force, introduce much higher stress and then gradual loads, requiring special design consideration. Okay. What is the sudden force? Like accident happen to the car, to the motorcycle, when it collides with something. Okay. It has sudden forces. Okay. We don't want that to happen to us, to anybody. But we observe in the news report, accident happened. This will cause the sudden force and we damage the vehicles. Okay. Safety factor variation, the balance between safety, weight and cost is crucial, particularly in fields like aerospace and automotive engineering. And lastly is the real world example. Similar challenges arise in bridge design, where vibration or vehicle loads can result in unexpected stresses. Also, design the bridge, we must consider many things. Okay. Earthquake, catastrophic failure and excessive loads and everything. So we must consider that. Okay, that's all for the video right now. Inshallah, we meet you in again in another video. Thank you very much.